Hey everybody, so today I'm here to bring you the review of the EvenFlo Revolve 360 all-in-one car seat. It is a mouthful. I'm going to go over some of the basic details first, then some of the more thorough details, and then finally at the end of the video, give you our thoughts and opinions. We've been using this car seat with our two-year-old daughter, Lexi, for well over a month now. I've been meaning to get this done for a couple weeks now, but when you have a car seat that you just use really regularly, kind of hard to get it out, get it cleaned, and all that good stuff. So I do have some overlay clips where you can see it in the car and you can see just what it looks like in real life. There's gonna be crumbs in it. There's gonna be other things going on because she sits in it, she eats in it, she rides in it. It's getting used. So I wanted to be sure to include that in the video just so you guys could see authentically what a car seat actually looks like inside of our car. Also to get a feel for what it looks like in an actual seat so you can see what it looks like all strapped in, installed correctly, ready to be used. So I will include clips like that, but we're just gonna go ahead and get started. So I will link the car seat down below for you guys. I'm gonna link you to AlbeeBaby. They usually have 20% off coupons that will work on car seats. It's normally the first three letters of the given month that you're in, and then the number 20. So for example, I'm filming this in October, so it'd be OCT20. And normally it gives you 20% off. It doesn't work for every brand, but when we did buy this car seat, it did work. So I just want to throw that out there. I have used AlbeeBaby.com since our oldest needed a car seat. Our very first car seat we bought for our almost 7-year-old daughter all the way back in 2014. Have had nothing but good experiences, fast shipping. They always come as they should. So I'm gonna link you there because in my experience spending that amount of money, that's who I trust and that's who I personally turn to. Next up, I also want to mention my husband is outside painting our side deck. So if you hear some thumping, bumping around, stuff like that, ignore it, stay with me. He's just got to get stuff done during nap time just like I do. So like I said, let's go over just the general details first and then I'll give you a look at the car seat in the more thorough, in-depth kind of things. So it is an all-in-one car seat, which means it is a rear-facing convertible car seat, a forward-facing convertible car seat, and also a booster seat. So that's what it means from all-in-one. You can use this car seat in the multiple different ways I just listed, from 4 pounds to 120 pounds, from 17 inches to 57 inches. So you can see there's a wide range here. You can pretty much, depending obviously on circumstances, and this will be different for everybody, but for most people, be able to use it from birth all the way up until 120 pounds whenever your kid hits that limit and the height limit of 57 inches. So quite some time. As far as the weight of the car seat itself, it is 29.6 pounds. Just some information. I feel like I get asked that in about every car seat review and it never occurs to me, but I just wanted to throw it in here in case you need that information. So for rear facing, the limits are 4 pounds to 40 pounds, 17 inches to 40 inches. For forward facing, the limits are 22 pounds to 65 pounds, 28 inches to 49 inches. And the booster method, the limits are 40 pounds to 120 pounds and 44 inches to 57 inches. Also, just another couple tidbits. The expiration is 10 years from when it was manufactured. The listing that I will also include down below to EvenFlo, it actually goes over a lot of this information really nicely in their listing for the car seat. So if you're ever curious about more specs and details and stuff like that, I'm gonna link that because they did a really good job on their website. I'm also gonna link you to an article by this car seat tech website that I trust, thoroughly recommend if you're ever looking into car seats. And they do a ton of specific information in their reviews. So I'll link the one on this one as well. I also wanted to point out that currently it's not FAA approved, which means right now you can't fly with this kind of car seat. It's not one that you could take on an airplane. All right, so now I'm just gonna scoot you guys back and I'm gonna show you the car seat itself. Okay, so here's a look at the shell itself. I just wanted to kind of show this off before I go over the detailed features. But of course, you have the headrest. We actually have the little insert still in here because it fits our daughter really well. However, if your child does outgrow it, you can take it out. There was also an infant insert, which I took out because obviously our two-year-old is not an infant, but I don't know where I put it, so please forgive that. And then you do have some pads on the straps here. Let me zoom you guys in. Now, the bottom part of these are fixated. My husband did look into this, and the top part is removable, but this bottom part does always stay on. There's also kind of like an anti-slip material underneath, kind of like a rubber, so they don't scoot around. However, just know that these pads on here are pretty much fixated. I think the top just comes off for easy washing. And then down here, you do have the chest clip. I am enjoying the fact that more and more companies are putting on here things like this that explain to anybody putting the child in the car seat where the chest clip is supposed to go. Even further down here, you do have the crotch buckle. There is two different positions for that. Right here is where you tighten or loosen your straps, and it's actually tucked all the way underneath this fabric right here, and it's a whole finger length that you have to pretty much stick down there and press the button, so no small child is going to be able to reach that and undo that themselves. You also have cup holders on either side. They're not removable in the respect that you can't just remove them from the seat and not use them. However, they are removable in the sense where they twist to one side and you can pop them out like this and you can wash them. They are also machine washable or dishwasher safe, I meant to say. They have this on the bottom. So when you put it down in, you just want to match that up, push down, and then twist to the right. And then your cup holder is back to being secure and it cannot be grabbed out. You can probably see a couple other things like this right here and also underneath the headrest, this gray piece peeking out right here. These are belt pads for when it turns into a booster seat. And then right up top here, you do have the headrest adjustment. So you just pull this, you can pull up, you can go all the way down, depending obviously on what fits your child. And that is really smooth. It works really nicely. But this is where you're going to squeeze to rotate the seat. And there is one on either side. So left and right, you just tuck your hand behind here and you pull up and you can swivel the seat. So that's a look at the inside of the car seat. So on the sides here, they just have some more helpful info when it comes to installing and also just the different guides and what's safe for what recline. And then on the back of the seat, right up here, up towards the headrest, this is actually your recline button. So you click this and you're able to do the different recline options. There is a place for storage for your manual right there, which is where ours is. And okay, so that was a look at the shell. Like I said, this is a look at the base. So obviously they work together, but taking it out, we did have to separate it. So I just kind of wanted to highlight this fact that the shell is removable from the base itself. This is what they call the lock strong bar. It's basically a tensioning plate for all intents and purposes, to explain it really simply. So this is just a method of how to install it. There are latch anchors that you can use up to a certain weight limit. Make sure to check your usual user manual for that. But the recommended install is with the seatbelt, because I'll get to it here in a second, but that's how they would prefer for you to install it. So this lock strong bar just has to do with installing the car seat with the seatbelt. So that's what it kind of looks like there. You also have the tether on the base itself. So this is pretty unique. It's not on the shell, it's on the base. You'll see how that comes into play and how that is a benefit here in a moment. So on either side of the seat, right about here, they have this little color indicator to show you if the seat is locked or not into position. The swivel feature is only to be used when you're placing the child into the car seat. After that, you're supposed to lock it into position, and any time that the car is in motion or about to be in motion, it needs to be in the lock position. So right now, obviously it's red because there's not even a shell on it, but you want it to be green when it is nice, locked, ready to go. Also, I just wanted to kind of point this out. There's also a nice little QR code down here. So you're able to scan that and you can get more information on your car seat. And then on the bottom here, like I said, there are the latch systems, but those only go up to a certain weight limit. So like I said, please make sure that you're reading your manual. And that's about everything to do with the base itself. Now I'm just gonna hook the two together. I don't know if you noticed it, but here on the base, there are two white arrows, one right here and one right here. So that indicates to you where you need to be positioning the shell for it to go onto the base. Underneath this flap is a red arrow. So you're just lining up the red arrow to the white arrow. So then after putting it on, I just reclined it a bit and then I was able to put it on there. So here's a look at the base in the car seat itself. Like I said, I'm going to include some actual videos of it in my car. Who cares what it looks like on my couch right here? So I'm going to overlay some of those clips right now and then just go on about some of the features. So as far as the features goes, it's an all-in-one seat. I already explained that, the three different ways that you can use this. So it is supposed to grow with your child. There's also the Sure 360, which are the indicators that the seat is in the proper position. There's also the Lock Strong Bar, which, like I showed, has to do with the install. And then also the Tether 360. So the tether is not attached to the shell, so it is able to swivel both in forward-facing and rear-facing modes. This is going to allow it to truly be a one-time install. That's something that their website mentions a lot, that you're able to install it once and that's all you're going to have to do. So this is truly what makes it a one-time install and allows that to be possible. Like I showed, you are able to do that by the handles. Also, the shell does come off the base, like I've also already showed you. So this is really good for cleaning. That's where my mind went for the first time when I saw that, because I was super excited. You know, when your kid drops the goldfish, the snacks, the whatever down in there, you're able to detach it, get in there, clean what you need to. All right, so we're back to just me in the seat now, and I thought I would go over just kind of our thoughts and opinions in the month of using this. So right off the bat, if we're being completely honest, I did not expect to really enjoy this car seat. We got it more so because it is pretty much a direct competitor to the existing car seat we already had, the Cybex Sirona S. That is also a swivel car seat. It is different. I have a complete review of that one as well, which I will link down below for you. However, they're direct competitors. So we thought, why not test them out? Because there is a price difference. There is just differences in the car seat altogether. If you guys are interested in seeing a comparison, definitely let me know down in the comments below. That'll be a separate video. I don't want that to turn into this. Not everybody's going to be interested in the Cybex, so this is just a review of this. However, I think it's important to show that I already had a swivel car seat. I thought that I was in love with that one. I really didn't see how this one would hold up to that one. So going into that, that was kind of my perspective. It was biased, and I'm being honest with that. So when it got here, I was immediately impressed, though. From taking it out of the box, how it was packaged, everything, I was thoroughly impressed. And the fact that you do have to separate the shell from the base to even install the car seat, so you notice that really quickly, I was amazed. I didn't know that that was a feature, and I was so happy because, like I said, that allows for easy cleaning and if an accident happens in the car seat, only having to take the shell out, take it inside. Like, there's so many different aspects as somebody who has used car seats for almost 7 years now that made me really excited for that feature. So just right off the bat, I was really impressed with it. We also noticed that the swivel was much easier than what we were used to. Like I said, don't want to make this a comparison, but I was thinking at first, well, that doesn't seem very easy. However, it really is. And the way that it does actually swivel is very smooth. It's really nice. And you don't have to put a whole lot of work into swiveling it yourself. You know, it basically kind of does the motions for you. You just have to keep that handle lifted up. I will say from a kid perspective, I think Lexi enjoys this one more. The recline, the recess in the sides over here allows her to hang her legs out, and she loves doing that. Also, this little flap down here that actually pushes up whenever it's rear facing against the base. She enjoys every bit of this car seat. She seems to be really comfortable. Obviously, she can't give me a thorough in-depth review, but just as my kind of observation of my own kid and how they behave in car seats, that was my takeaway from it. I feel like all around, it's been very easy for us to use. It's been really nice. The install, I will say, is a couple extra steps than what I think most people are used to. However, I think it's 100% worth it. Like I mentioned, the whole one-time install, the tensioning plate, things like that, the whole reason why it's recommended that you use the seatbelt versus the latch system is so that it's a one-time install. Because the latch system has a weight limit, and all car seats do, by the way, not just this one. Anytime you're using a latch system, which is the two things that you can latch onto your actual seat in your car, those all have weight limits that you have to be aware of. At some point, your kid will grow out of those and you have to do the seatbelt method anyways. So because of that, they do recommend that you do the seatbelt install initially. That way it's one time and you're done, which I think is really cool. The fact that the tether is on the base and not the shell also helps that.
I just can't say enough good things. When you're switching from forward facing to rear facing, there's nothing you have to do other than swivel the seat, which is really, really cool. That can't be said for some other models. So there were a couple things that we weren't huge fans of. So the first one being the strap pads. They just don't budge. And honestly, thinking about it now, it's not a huge deal if your child is older. Like with my almost 7 and 5-year-old, I really don't think that'd be an issue for them. They don't really move anyways whenever they're in their other car seat. However, when you have a toddler, just, you know, they're wiggly. Sometimes you gotta adjust things depending on their clothes, like all that kind of stuff. I just wish they were actually detachable or they could actually move with the child. Not a huge deal, just something that we both noticed. And the last thing is something that my husband and I actually kind of disagree on. I'm not sure that it's entirely reading on camera because it's kind of so minuscule, it's hard to see, but there is a slight slant at which the car seat rests when you have it turned to the side and you're going to put your child in the car seat. My husband doesn't care for it. He doesn't like it. He thinks it makes it a little bit more complicated to get them in the seat. However, I disagree with him, and that's why I also wanted to bring this up, because everyone's different. Everyone's gonna have something they like of a car seat and something that they don't. And right here is just an example of how my husband and I differ. He notices that slant, he doesn't care for it. Me, I have never really noticed it until he pointed it out. And even then, I haven't noticed any kind of issues. I've been able to get her in the car seat fine every time. So my overall thoughts with this car seat is that it was really well thought out, pretty well executed. We have no big complaints about it. Lexi enjoys it. We like using it. It's not complicated to use. And I'm gonna have to look into this a bit more, but I really think that the shell and base thing is really interesting. I saw a review on their website mentioning how if they sold extra bases, it really could be kind of like an infant carrier where you just swap out the shell. And I thought that was such an interesting idea, because whether you are co-parenting or you just are a multi-vehicle kind of home, or your child is in someone else's car quite frequently, there's just multiple different reasons why this could be super easy. It's not like an entire extra car seat. It's something that is pretty easy to swap over. We've just thoroughly enjoyed it. And like I said in the beginning of the video, I didn't plan on enjoying it or even liking it more than the one that we already had. But if we're being completely honest, moving forward, this is going to be the car seat that's in my car for Lexi. She likes it so much, I like it so much, that this is the one that we're going to be sticking with moving forward. So I would 10 out of 10 definitely recommend this car seat if you are interested in it. I will have it linked at AlbeeBaby down below for you guys. Remember to try and use the coupon code, first 3 letters of the month and the number 20. I don't get anything from that. That's just an AlbeeBaby coupon that's pretty much all the time. Every single month they have that. And I will also link those couple other things, the article and also the EvenFlo listing, if you need more information on this car seat. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments below. I'll do my best to answer them. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And as always, thanks for watching.